Thanks for driving me to work, Min.
Oh, hello, Mork. Mindy. Hi. I'm glad you're here early, Mork. I have bad news. Oh. Mr. Paul Simpson, the man we leased this daycare center from, also owns the roller disco place across the street. Our lease is up at the end of the month, and Mr. Simpson isn't going to renew it. He's going to tear down the daycare center and make it a parking lot for the skating rink.
Oh, no, he can't do that. I mean, what'll happen to all the little munchkins? They can't play hopscotch in the fast lane.
God only knows. Mr. Simpson called, and he's going to come over here this morning and explain things. If he appears, I'll be back in a second.
But...
Oh, Mork, we've got to put our heads together. Those little kids are going to be thrown out in the streets.
Yeah, I'll give that Mr. Simpson a piece of my mind, or at least a hunk of my frontal lobe there, Min. I mean, eviction of little munchkins, boy, that's rude. I mean, we can't be mean to kids. What, this isn't a Joan Crawford daycare center. It's,
you know, if it's the Paul Simpson, he's really a powerful man. I mean, he owns half of Boulder.
Well, we'll just have to tell Mr. the Paul Simpson that he's dealing with Mork the Defender. Ooh, he's making my jaws tight, Min. If I ever see him, I'm going to hear him, what four? What five?
Excuse me.
Give me what six? What six and a half?
I'm Paul Simpson.
Oh. What for? Oh, please. Don't throw the little Yodas out, Master Simpson. Please, don't you understand? I mean, you can't tear down the orphanage. But then little orphan Annie and Oliver Twist to be thrown out in the cold to be picked up by Fagin and forced to lie, cheat, and steal. Then they'll take him to Hollywood and work in B movies. And they'll never have an answer. They'll never know.
Lighten up.
Ooh.
And it's not an orphanage, it's a daycare center.
Well, who ever heard of little daycare center Annie?
Excuse me, Mr. Simpson. But if you tear down the daycare center, what'll the kids do when their parents go to work?
Oh, I don't want to see this place torn down, but I'm not doing it. My son is.
You mean you don't own the roller disco?
Well, technically I do, but I bought the place and gave it to my son.
Can't you tell him not to tear this place down?
Oh, I have to let him do it his way. He's always been irresponsible, a troublemaker. The only thing he can do well is skate. So I bought that rink and gave it to him, hoping it would straighten him up. It seems to be working, so I'm not going to interfere.
I can understand your concern for your son, but what about all those little kids?
Well, I'm going to wait here for Mrs. Fowler. Why don't you go down and talk to my son, Wheels?
Wheels? Is that a family name?
Well, his real name is Carol. For some reason, he prefers to be called Wheels.
Skating in such a long time. I hope I don't fall down and hurt myself.
Mindy, what's the big deal here? We're not flying to the moon. Just talking a little skating, a little gravity, a little friction.
Yeah, well, it's not that easy, Mork. Have you ever done it?
Mindy, how hard can it be? I mean, you've got four wheels in each foot. Ever seen an eight-wheeler tip over? A Peterbilt go, pfft, no way. Come on home, I'm gonna take anything you need. See?
Ta-da.
No big deal.
Oh, no big deal. You're walking on the carpet.
Mindy, I mean, we Orkans are born balancers. I mean, we can waltz on water. We can tap dance on tapioca. See this? Watch out there. We can also polka on the head of a pin. You know, we.
May he help me, you know?
Oh, look, you shouldn't balance on, you know.
I just don't understand how those eight-wheelers stay upright.
Good, here comes Wheels. Why don't we catch him while he's alone?
It's all right, Mindy. I'm okay. I'm all right. You go on. I just have a little cramp in my shoelace. I'll be okay. I'm a superior being.
Okay. Is Mindy McConnell, and I have a friend who'd like to talk to you.
Oh, well, where is your friend? He can talk to me while I'm scraping up the gum.
He's over here. Oh. beans.
Would you get to the point? Wheels is busy.
Here, you gotta sign it.
All right, but I'm not gonna sign a Carol. I'm signing it Wheels.
Well, see, I shouldn't be the one that talks to you about this, because Mork is the one who has the bone to pick.
Oh, you must be Wheels.
You must be Toes.
Oh, you kid. Actually, I'm Mork from the daycare center.
You go to daycare center? Shoot, I was in jail at your age.
He works there.
I suppose you know all the reasons why you shouldn't tear it down.
Nope.
Nope.
Negative echo in here, isn't it?
What about the children?
We'll try to get most of them out before we flatten the place.
Wait a minute here. What kind of a human being are you? What kind of a sentient? Wait, what kind of what?
Porky, he doesn't even know how to skate.
Now, look, Chicky Poo. If you don't like the way I do business, you can get your perky little pigtails out of here.
Whoa!
Are you sure I can't change your mind about that daycare center?
You've got about as much chance of that as you do about skating me.
Mork, I'm gonna fall.
I accept your bet. What bet, buddy?
Will you stop on me? What? Will you let go of me? Now, what bet?
Well, you said that if I beat you in skating, you change your mind. Well, I accept your challenge.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Mm-hmm. I didn't say that.
Oh, are we just going to a different beat now, Mr. Thing?
You hear that, everybody? Wheels, the professional, says that he doesn't want to race Mort, the beginner, huh? Whoa.
Man, he's quaking in his skates right now, isn't he?
Hey, Wheels, they're laughing at you.
Don't be silly. I'm not afraid of him. Okay, I'll race him.
You hear that, everybody?
He accepts my challenge, man.
Look, you can't beat him.
Oh, man. Now, I am a superior alien being. Remember that.
Okay, then let's get this straight. If Mork wins, then the daycare center stays, and if you win, it becomes a parking lot.
Hey, what difference is it going to make anyway, huh? How many laps around the rink, clown?
Clown?
No home rink advantage for you. Mm-mm, no way.
Here comes the superior part, men. Watch this.
This is the only rink in Boulder where you're supposed to skate.
We're going to skate in the Rockies.
Rocky Mountains?
That's the superior part.
We're going to start up at Eagle Point, skate down through Boulder Mountain Park, end up at the mall.
It's 10 miles and steep, and there might be snow.
Ooh, a little bop, 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 bop. Hmm? Are we writing a little check with our mouth that our feet can't cash, maybe? We don't know. Are you in, big guy, or not?
I guess I'm in.
Oh, yeah.
Saturday, high noon. Be there or be square.
You've got the oldest trick in the book. It's in the solar system guidebook.
Watch this one. You're a rink skater. But up there on the mountain, where there's no strobe light, no disco beat, and no spandex, you're equal.
Well, I gotta admire a guy that can put one over on me.
Wheels, why don't you let the smart guy read your belt buckle?
Sure, I enjoy a little light reading.
Colorado State Rink Street Cross Country Skate Champion. Pretty.
You know, Mindy, Mork simply doesn't have a chance to win that race.
Oh, I agree. He got up before dawn to start training. That was 6 hours ago.
He seems to have a will, but there's no way.
I think I hear Rocky now.
Oh, man, you see this finger?
Yeah.
That's the only part of my body that doesn't hurt. And that's because I think it's a clean break.
Oh,
Hello, Fred. Mork, you look terrible.
Oh, I was all right, Fred, until I skinned my eyes.
Min? You never guess who I ran into, Mindy.
Ooh. Well, you beat me, but no fair. You took a shortcut through the rose hedge.
Dad, this is Glenda Faye Comstock. Well, we went to high school together.
Yes, yes.
I've always liked you, Mr. McConnell.
How? Oh. Yes.
Oh, where'd you run into Glenda Faye?
Well?
He ran into me here, then here, and a little later, right down here. Mindy, do you mind if I use your bathroom? I'd like to powder my bruises.
Sure.
Excuse me.
Well, I really admire your spirit. 6 hours of training.
Well, where'd you go?
Well, Mindy, you wouldn't believe this, but I went all the way around the block.
How many times?
Times? Mork, you can't learn to skate like a professional in a week.
Oh, Fred, I've got to do it for the kids. And besides, I can't lose. Mm-mm, no way.
Why can't you lose?
Well, because this is the land of the home, free of the brave. Because the good guys always win, and that's me.
Who says the good guys always win?
Oh, Fred, movies, television. I mean, look at that. I mean, it's American way. I mean, when's the last time you saw Genghis Khan ride off into the sunset? All right, you little Mongols, head your little ponies up.
Or
when's the last time you saw Peter Lloyd ride off into the sunset? Happy trails to you until we meet again.
You're very pretty.
You see? It's determination. Determination. It's the little skater who thought he could. I think I can. Can, yes, I can, yes, I can. Ah, see? Determination, Fred. And that's what I've got lots of. My middle name is Mr. D.
Good afternoon, fellow Boulderites. I'll be receiving reports throughout the course of the race by spotters using walkie-talkies. And I see by the old watch on the wrist that the race is about to start. Yes, our two daredevils should be getting ready to start the race right about now up at the top of Eagle's Peak.
Hey, you know your route.
Nice.
You go down Oak Street, you turn onto Pearl, and then you go right into Boulder Mall.
Right, Boulder Mall. Well, it's
too bad they don't make those in loafers, huh, man?
Look at that helmet. He looks like Amelia Earhart.
Hey, he's nothing.
Watch out for the potholes.
Potholes, yeah.
And the ice, it's slippery.
Yeah, that's fine.
Like that.
I like that.
And keep your vest buttoned. You don't want to catch cold.
Thanks, Mother Mind.
Hello, Wales. Hello, Sleazy Second. Say hi to the warden.
I got everything we need in the van, and I put them tires where you told me to.
Good. I know I can beat this turkey, but I don't want to take any chances. Come on, let's go. Okay, Boz, let's get this over with.
Oh, good luck, Moore. You can do it, I hope.
Sure I can, Min. Been up trained for a week.
On your mark. Get set.
Well, I've got to wish you good luck. May the best. Excuse me, I think.
Go.
Well, I think I better shoot that thing again. He's a little far away. I don't think he heard it.
What kind of a start was that?
A nice, clean start.
Get going! Oh, Mark, go! Come on, go!
Guys always win. Now, all it takes is a little total concentration. Now, I can't let anything distract me.
Orson calling Mort. Come in, Mork.
Not now, Orson. I'm busy. Whew. Gotta get an unlisted head. Those tires in the middle of...
Oh, no, someone could...
Where do you come from?
Oh, little spot called Death's Door. I'd like to talk to you about the start of that race. You see, where I come from, it's usually ready, set, bang, skate, not ready, set, skate, bang. I know it's a very subtle difference, but... Speaking of where'd you come from, how did you get beside those tires?
What tires?
What tires are... Rapidly mounting suspicions here. I know there's something wrong, but I can't pinpoint it. Look who caught up to Mr. Champion. I'm glad. Makes this easier.
Oh, hope I land on something soft.
I heard pine was a soft wood.
Here, let me help you. Take my arm.
It's plenty.
I know. Oh. Get a grip.
Thank you.
Are you okay?
Oh, man, I thought the good guys always win.
Not when the bad guys cheat.
Yeah, but I don't want to cheat, man. I don't want to do anything rash.
Well, be rash. How are you going to catch him?
Well, it's a drastic measure, but I could always induce translinear facial molecular motion.
Could you translate that into Earthling, please?
Well, basically, it's a time warp, Min. Yeah, but I can't do it for very long, and I don't know if I have enough time to catch him anyway.
Mork, at this point, you gotta try anything you can.
Look who's telling me to cheat.
I'm not telling you to cheat. He's the one that's cheating. And anyway, you're doing it for the kids.
Yeah, the little munchkins. You're right, Min. I'll see you at the finish line if I don't burn up on reentry.
Oh.
Big kiss.
Wait. Good luck.
Thank you. I can't catch him on the road. I have to take a shortcut. Au revoir.
Wait a minute, you're gonna skate down there through the grass? Skating through the grass.
I just got word from one of our spotters that Wheel Simpson is in town and headed toward the finish line. Mork is nowhere in sight. Well, it looks like Wheels is an easy winner, ladies and gentlemen. Wheels is coming down the... Wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen. Our spotter says that Mork is in town and skating towards the mall.
Why are you slowing down? Use your time warp.
I'm all warped out, Min.
I don't get it. The bad guys are winning and the good guys are here sucking air.
You can do it. What about all that talk about determination and drive?
Oh, you're right, Min. I can't let a little thing like physical exhaustion stop me.
Right, go.
Oh, yeah, drive. You want to see drive?
Yeah.
Next, stop the winner's circle.
Good.
Here I go, Min. There I go.
Mork.
I know.
You can do it, Mork.
Yeah, you're right. This one's for you, Munchkin. Is your last name Gipper?
Shucks and wazoo, Min.
Way to go, Mork. What you did took a lot of courage and stupidity.
Oh, thank you.
We're all very proud of you, Mork.
Well, this is really exciting, Min. I think I beat the best, didn't I?
Yeah, you did.
I guess that makes me top skate now, doesn't it?
You know, people be skating from all over the country going, yo, yo. Maybe I should have brought my own roller disco rink, maybe. You know, so I can teach John Q. Public how to really skate flat. I've learned some basic moves, Min. Besides,
watch yourself, baby!
Calling Orson. Come in, Orson. Mark calling Orson. Come in, Orson.
Mark calling Orson. Come in your equator ship.
I'm here, Mark. What's your report this week?
Well, sir, this week I raced a human on roller skates and won.
What did you win?
Oh, the race, sir. But the real winners were the little children who got to keep their daycare center.
Do Earthlings always race on skates?
Oh, no, sir. They're different kind of races. There's dog races, horse races, auto races.
It sounds like racing is very popular there, Mork.
Well, sir, it is. And the most wonderful race of all could be the human race. If they only realize that they're all on the same team, all they need is some kind of international referee. You know, some... Bing! You know, sir, I think I look awfully good in black and white stripes, don't you? Try and follow me on this one.
Prisoner, 15 miles, illegal invasion. Castro, you're out of the game, smoking in the huddle. I mean, you'd be out of the game, too, if we could find you. Whoa, there you are, you little fucker.
Until next week, sir. Nanu, nanu.